Hi, my name is Tom, and welcome to Living Through Limit. Today, I'm going to work on my swamp cooler, also called an evaporative cooler, trying to get ready for summer. So I just thought I'd show you how to go about servicing your cooler for the summer. I took it all apart, the cooler's up, way up there. I covered it, took the water off, I drained it, and a cooler was put in probably a couple years ago. So what I'm going to do today, I'm going to hook the water back up. It does freeze here, and so I disconnected the water, drained it out so it wouldn't freeze the water line. So we got to uncover it, and I'm going to run. I picked up some white vinegar, if I can get it in the picture here. White vinegar. I've got a dustpan, an oil can, these, and I'll show you in a bit, but these swamp coolers also have bushings, and they need to be oiled every year, just so you don't wear those bushings out. The pads, if you take care of them on these coolers, can usually be ran for, you know, 2 or 3, maybe 4 years. With using the white vinegar, it'll help clean out the calcium deposits and stuff. Let's get going on taking the cover off, which, oh, the other thing I've done is I got me a chair, because if I can get it in the camera here, right there, because my feet don't always work when you're working on your limits. You gotta be prepared. I would have done this yesterday, but I knew my legs wouldn't hold me on a ladder. So I've got a couple of ladders set up here. I got one there. I got one over here, so I don't have to move the ladders around. I don't know if you can see this on camera, but this panel's got a lot of white in here and stuff. I'm hoping the running that white vinegar in here for a while will help cure that issue. The other thing I got myself, it's just a paintbrush, kind of clean this up a little bit. I think what I'm going to do too is I'll probably run the white vinegar and then drain this whole, I'll have to drain the whole thing out again and get a lot of that cleaned out of here. The oil areas I was talking about here, these have little caps on them, but they have little wicks in here, and you just take a little bit of oil in that wick. Helps keep it on the bushing and keep that bearing in there, which is basically a bushing, from wearing out. Okay, so we see a lot of scale in here, and I'm going to clean a lot of that up. Another oil spot in there, right in here, and check the belt tension, which looks good. Okay, so we're going to take oil can, which is an overkill, but what I have. We're going to open up the little keeper and squirt oil in there. We hope. Whoops, I overfilled it, but hey, better too much than not enough. So this is the drain overflow. It goes right in here. And that gives us our level of water, and if we get too full, it does two things for us. One, it'll keep from overfilling, and two, if this is leaking, you know it's overfilling. So then what we got to do, there's our float, and we're going to want to see how our water level's doing, so we're going to climb back down off the ladder real carefully, and we can check our line, make sure nothing froze. What a mess we have out here, huh? This is getting slowly cleaned up too. Trash can lid doesn't belong on top of the air conditioner. I do have an air conditioner, and we can look for any leaks. It looks like nothing's leaking there. It looks like our copper tubing held up over the winter. This is the float, and if we pull up on that a little bit, it stops running, so we know that's still working. And it takes a little bit of time to fill this up this way. You can always grab a hose and fill it up quicker. The pump's over there. Pump looks like it's still in pretty good shape, but what we're going to do is once I get the water level filled up, I'm going to put the other filter pad back on, and then I'm going to run this for about 3 or 4 hours, and that'll help break down any of that white calcium deposits in this thing, hopefully. And then we'll drain this, refill it, and we'll be ready to run for the summer. We can check our belt tension. Looks like we're good. So, and we'll let this run, and we'll come back and check it a little later. Okay, I thought I would just show this little part. You know, when you're working on your body limits, financial limits and everything, these are just small videos of what you can take care of yourself to keep from having to pay somebody else to come and service your swamp cooler. But just really know that you've got to work within your body limits. You know, it's like I'm sitting down right now. My legs get shaky and stuff, and when that happens, you just get down off the ladder. It's better to climb down than to fall down. While I'm waiting for that water up here, I can clean up my mess and just move on with the day. Inside my house is where I actually turn my swamp cooler on. Instead of having a window mount, it can either be mounted on a wall, it could be mounted on a roof and come down. I have it I used duct pipe and went through the attic and then came out in the living room. Makes it work really nice because it kind of spreads that air throughout the house instead of just coming in a window. So I'm going to get this stuff cleaned up, and then hopefully by then this water's about done running and we can turn that pump on and check it out and keep going from there. Now a little earlier, I could hear that motor humming, but it wasn't running. So something locked it up. Well, it's been several months. This thing's been sitting here. So sometimes you can take, instead of buying a whole new pump, you can reach in here with a pair of needle nose pliers and I unplugged it up here at the controller so I didn't have to go back in the house back and forth. And let's see. You can see that shaft in there. You can take, because it's a real low horsepower motor. Let's see, can we see any water coming down through there? Usually you can see little drops kind of running down, but right now these pads are so dry. But anyhow, we'll come back after this thing's ran for several hours. 10:03, so probably around 2 or 3 o'clock we'll come back out here. Hello. Well, it might be a little dark over here. We're going to check on the swamp cooler now. I decided to let it go an extra amount of hours. It's actually the next day. White vinegar works really well, but it's really a light duty, I don't know if you'd call it an acid or whatever, so it takes a while to go through, and so I just decided to let it run till nighttime. I turned off the swamp cooler, and now we're just going over to shut the water off. We ran the vinegar in here for, I don't know, it must have been like 10 hours or so. It really, I don't know if you can see over there, there's the pump, and that screen that was under the pump was really plugged up, and it cleaned it off really good. And actually, it cleaned where the pads are running. It cleaned that all up really good. So I think what I'm going to do, I was going to drain this, but there's not much of an odor, so I'm just going to run it, and that way it helps clean out a lot of the vinegar smell. So I'm going to open this up. And I have to use two hands with mine because it doesn't really like to cooperate sometimes. With the swamp cooler, what you have to do is it's pushing air into the home, okay? And so you create positive pressure. Well, you get to a certain point and there's no place for that air to go. So you have to open windows, and whatever rooms you want that air to go into, that is where you need to open those windows. So what we're going to do is we're going to walk over here to the window, open the window up. I have a switch I put in, and I want it on low cool, and I can hear my pump going off. Smells a little musty. It was sitting all year. So that was the swamp cooler reconditioned for this year. I want to thank you for watching this episode of Living Through Limits. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Leave me a comment. I really would love to have comments so I know where we can go in the future and figure out other videos to do. Thank you for watching. And remember, you too can live through your limits. Bye. My dog on the couch. Just thought I'd throw this in. She's such a good dog. My wife's dog, he's like 18 years old. He's a grumpy old man.
I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart.